All right, so I want to talk now more about stress fractures in one or more of the small bones that make up the lower back, right?
Yes.
With our little model here, which has been so helpful, we're hearing that it's becoming very common in adolescents and teen athletes, more aggressive, if you will, with the sports. What's going on?
Well, dependent upon stress fractures in the low back, or you would call it spondylolysis or spondylolisthesis. Mm-hmm. So those two terms are referred to or specifically to a certain area of the spine, of the vertebral column that would be fractured. And typically it's more so of an extension and rotation type of mechanism of injury repetitively happening to what's called the pars interarticularis. So if you look at this vertebra, and if I put my fingers here, these, that might be the nose of the dog, the snout of a dog, that would be an ear, these would be the feet. And so okay. If someone, if a doctor's looking on an x-ray and you're holding that up and you would call it a Scotty dog, and so you're looking at that aspect, which is called the pars interarticularis, and that's typically where a spinal stress fracture can happen. Stress fracture can progress into a full-blown fracture, and it can progress into on both sides. Suppose spondylolysis would be a fracture to the pars interarticularis. Spondylolisthesis would be a fracture to both sides, and then subsequently a forward slippage of one vertebra underneath the other.